Hi, I'm DJ Scotto, and I'm standing out in front of the shelter in Tribeca, New York City. This is the Hubert Street entrance. This is the historic American Express building. It's a historic landmark. The shelter was opened after area. They opened it as a non-alcoholic after-hours alternative. And primarily it was open on Saturday nights for the post-Paradise Garage crowd. NASA launched in July of 92 and closed exactly 1 year later on its anniversary. It finally closed in 2004 in the spring to become multi-million dollar luxury loft condominiums. All good things must come to an end, but it was a great club space that housed many clubs in many eras, from area in the 80s with the Andy Warhol crowd, to Quick, to Shelter, to then Vinyl, which was the home to Danny Taneglia and Little Louis Vega. And then it became ARC at the very end, and that's where we did our NASA 12-year anniversary. The shelter basically was, in that time period, there really was a lot of raves here in New York that were getting busted because they were in illegal, unlicensed warehouses. So I put together a kind of a collaboration so that it was a non-bustable type event. And the quality of the production was one of the foundations, as well as the music. And the music would flow based on the different DJs that we had, again, through the various styles. So we'd open up with house and go into some breaks and new house, and then go into what we had later called the Power Hour, which was more techno and harder sounds. And then as the after hours came, we would bring in, again, more newer house music artists like Doc Martin or Keoki would come. Influence and impact that it had, basically, it's considered to be the Studio 54 of the rave generation. But we basically planted the seeds for a whole new generation and paid homage to the house music heads. This was their home. NASA stood for Nocturnal Audio and Sensory Awakening. And at the time, it really was, there was a lot of changes happening, both in lighting and sound and technology and the music itself. And there was this, and you know, the internet was just becoming born, and you got a sense of it. There were Macintosh, you could design your flyers on the computer and scan things, and this was all new. Well, we saw the future, and we knew that what we were doing was gonna make a difference. I like. NASA wanted to define a music sound, we chose a format that was heavy on breakbeat, that with that amen break and the happy hardcore UK sound. Bands like The Prodigy, tracks like Plastic Dreams was a big track. It broke in the rave scene before it broke in the house music culture. But we also showcased techno and experimental, and we had a chill out room in the back here. I had been the technical director at Limelight, came in with Michael Alleg and Disco 2000 and did all the lighting. And at some point, as techno became popular with the Bridge and Tunnel crowd, I decided to leave the Limelight and I started throwing a few parties at Danceteria. And then I went to the original Studio 54 space, which was then called the Ritz. And I did a series of parties, Manhattan's first rave parties called Rave the Ritz, were a precursor to my team that I formed here at NASA. The sound man at the Ritz, Charlie Martin, introduced me to Charles Benante, who had a recording studio below the Studio 54 Ritz space, and it's called Soundworks. And you know, Shep Pettibone, Madonna, everyone recorded there, and introduced me, and we came down to the shelter, and it was a perfect spot. So I brought a team of people together. This became their new home.
Hey, this is Scotto. Deep is on tonight, so leave your name and number, and I'll get back to you. Peace.
Hi, Scotto. It's Kelly. Listen,
Scotto, dude, man, this is Chris. Look, we want to go to that party tonight, but we don't know where it is.
Call me back when you...
Yeah, I want you to call me. He's not home. We'll leave a message.
Yeah. Yeah, just walk in a shot. It's no problem.